In this lecture, we will give this photo a white stroke and a curved shadow. For the stroke, I copy and paste the image. Then I click on stroke and click on white. I set line width to 5 mm. To reveal the whole image, I right click and choose lower. And to see the white border, I will place a colored rectangle below. To select the image with the border, I control click on the image to select the object directly below it. Now let's place the drop shadow. I open the drop shadow panel. I click on as drop shadow. I want the shadow to be less dark and more centered. To reposition the shadow, I click behind X offset. I press 0 and also give in the other values by pressing the tab key. I set the opacity of the shadow to 50%. By quickly zooming in and out, I force the preview of the shadow to be refreshed. Now let's curve the shadow. If I modify the shape, I insert a node and move it, it becomes clear I need a duplicate of the border. So I copy and paste the image with the border. Since I also copied the shadow, I will deactivate it. I right click and lower the shadowless image. And I control click to select the shadow below. For my shadow, I prefer not to curve the stroke. A curved stroke can produce spikes, which would then stick out. To solve this, I go to Item, Convert to, Polygon, to convert the image frame to a normal shape. I go back to Item, Path Tools, Create Path from Stroke, to turn the stroke of this shape into a path. Now I have an actual edge to work with. I insert a node to the edge of the shape. I drag the node up. I need the curve to be smooth, so I'll add control points to the node. I reposition the node, to get a realistic result. Now I would like the photo and shadow to be one object. I drag over the objects, right click, and choose, group. To see the shadow again, I must remove content clipping, by deselecting group clips contents. I can now move, and scale the image. Let's also place a pushpin on top. I found one at pixabay.com, which is a great resource for free images and vector graphics. In Scribus, I go to File, Import, Get Vector File. I select the SVG file, and open it. I click to place it. And I control drag a corner to make it smaller.